Hey guys, Miss Siobhan here, back with you for another great Sunday with Freedom Kidz. So, y'all know how we do. First, we have to praise and worship, but before we do that, what I want you to do is grab your Bibles, because today's story comes from Matthew chapter 3, verse 1 through 17. So, at the end of our lesson, you guys know there will be questions. You can send those questions to Kidz, K-I-T-Z, at myfreedomdfw.com. So, we're going to get into some praise and worship before we get into our message. You guys, praise your heart out and worship our King and our Savior, and I'll be back with you after that.
Says, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. I dare you to throw your head back and shout unto the Lord if you're free.
Freedom.
always covering me.
In the days prior to Jesus' ministry on earth, a man who wore strange clothing and ate strange food was preaching a powerful message in the wilderness. His name was John, and he told crowds of people that the kingdom of heaven was about to appear, and that they should turn from their sins and wash themselves clean through the baptism. His emphasis on baptism earned him the name John the Baptist. As word of John the Baptist's message spread, crowds of people traveled to the Jordan River to confess their sins and be baptized. While many of these people were genuinely sorry for their sins, there were those who came only for show. These religious leaders, called Pharisees, came to be seen by the people, not because they wanted to be closer to God. John the Baptist warned them that God would not be fooled by imposters, and that only those with genuine faith would be received. John's warning to the Pharisees continued as he began to describe a very special man who would come after him. This man would be so great that John wouldn't even be worthy to touch his sandals. This man would baptize with the Holy Spirit and with fire. This great man John described would be the promised Messiah. As John the Baptist continued to baptize people in the Jordan River, many wondered about the man he had spoken of to the Pharisees. One day, a man from the town of Galilee came to be baptized. John the Baptist immediately knew who this man was. He was Jesus, the promised Messiah that John had told the Pharisees about. John was filled with awe and a bit of confusion. As Jesus approached, John the Baptist couldn't believe that Jesus would wade into the water with him. John, filled with confusion, asked Jesus, "Why are you doing this? I am the one who needs to be baptized by you, and yet you want me to baptize you?" Jesus reassured John by saying, "It is right to do all that God requires." In obedience to the Father, Jesus was baptized by John. This was an incredible moment in which Jesus, the perfect, sinless Son of God, identified with those he came to save. As Jesus was baptized, he entered into the pain and sin of all people. While Jesus had no sins to confess and be cleansed of, his baptism was an act of faith and obedience. As Jesus rose up out of the water, the heavens opened above him, and the Holy Spirit descended from heaven in the form of a dove that came to rest upon Jesus. This amazing sight was followed by the booming sound of the Father's voice saying, "This is my dearly loved Son who brings me great joy." Jesus' baptism serves as an example for us to follow.
All right, so let's talk about what we just watched. First of all, we have John the Baptist who was baptizing people, the Pharisees, the Jordan River, and Jesus. I know you guys watched the video. However, let me give you some background information. During the time that John the Baptist was baptizing people in the Jordan River, Israel was under rule by the Romans. I know, right? They're not even close to each other. But the people of Israel were waiting for their Messiah. So we have John the Baptist baptizing people. They're coming, they're changing their lives, and they are getting so hype about everything that John the Baptist is doing that they're starting to whisper that he's the Messiah. John the Baptist cleared that up real quick and said, no, there's one who's going to come after me, like after I'm gone, who is the Messiah, who will baptize people with the Holy Spirit and fire. And that man, he told them once again, would be the Messiah. He felt so strongly about it that he continued to baptize people in the Jordan River. And one day Jesus showed up. And in the video, I don't know if you remember, but it says that John the Baptist immediately knew who he was. He was overwhelmed. But because he lived by faith and in obedience to God, because remember he said he wasn't even going to be worthy to wash the Messiah's feet, he baptized Jesus. And when he did, a voice from heaven came and said, and boomed, right? This is my beloved son who brings me great joy. So let's talk about it. Jesus was perfect and born without sin. He really didn't need to be baptized, but he did it for three reasons. And these are your important parts. One, he wanted to identify with us. Jesus experienced everything we might encounter. He can relate to sad times and things going wrong. Think about it. His friend Lazarus died and it said he was sad. He had people talking about him, saying that he was crazy, all these things. So Jesus did this to identify with us, in addition to everything else he experienced when he came to earth as a man. He also did it to show humility. Baptism shows repentance for our sins and our disobedience from God. So Jesus left heaven to come and live as a man so he could be seen as an example for everyone. And then finally, Jesus was baptized because it leads us to God's family. When Jesus emerged from the water and the Holy Spirit descended on him, there was a voice from heaven that was God's voice that said, he was well pleased. When we're baptized, the same thing happens to us. So I want you guys to remember that. Our memory verse this week comes from Matthew chapter 3, verse 17. And behold, a voice from heaven said, this is my beloved son, with whom I am well pleased. Now y'all know we gotta remix it and make it our own. So I'm gonna teach you a little bit with some actual sign language in it. I'm not gonna tell you which is what, but follow me, okay? So, and behold, a voice from heaven said, this is my beloved son, with whom I am well pleased. Do that again. And behold, a voice from heaven said, this is my beloved son, with whom I am well pleased. Let's close in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for accepting us into your family through baptism. Thank you for sending your son to live as an example for us. Help us to live as closely to Jesus's example as possible. We ask these things in Jesus's name. Amen. Our game this week is called Baptism Beach Party. You need two towels and a ball. It could be a beach ball, a balloon, a tennis ball, a ping pong ball, whatever you have at home. You can make this work, I promise. One person will hold a beach towel with a ball in it. They are going to toss the ball to the other person and they're going to catch it. So think about it as the people that rejoiced when folks were getting baptized. They were having a party, celebrating, and you and your family or your brothers and sisters or cousins or whoever can have that same type of baptism beach party fun at home. See y'all later.